Joining me now is Dr. Paikiasothy Saravanamuttu. He's the Executive Director of the Centre for Policy Alternatives, a research institute here in Colombo known for its rare ability to speak without fear or favour on issues of human rights and the rule of law. Thanks for joining us, Doctor.
Thank you.
A fair introduction.
Thank you.
Well, you're a tough critic, but would you agree that things have vastly improved here in terms of civil rights and people's sense of freedom?
Well, I think what thing where things have improved, obviously, is that the killing has stopped insofar as there is no war. But if you talk to people in the North and East in general, there is a concern that the freedom that they expected as a consequence of the end of the war has yet to be realized. I think a lot of concern of people in the North, one hears constant reports and in talking to them, is about militarization, is about the presence of the army, the entry of the army into civic life, into the economy, the lack of a political settlement.
I certainly picked up on a greater sense of freedom, but I also very much picked up on a continuing sense of fear on certain topics. Well, what are those topics that you really can't talk about in Sri Lanka?
The basic gamut of sort of civil and political rights in terms of disappearances, detainees, surrendees, what happened to the missing, any talk about allegations of war crimes. Those are the kinds of things that, you know, lead to a great deal of fear and uncertainty. Secondly, I think as a consequence of that, there is also a fear and uncertainty about engaging in political activity that would be immediately suspect and be seen as evidence of a sort of resurgent militancy.
And why is there an exodus now when on the face of it, things have improved?
You see, the issue here is this, is that the government's argument at the present moment is the argument that now the war is over, terrorism is defeated. We have to focus on economic development. And that in the North and East in particular, being the areas in which the war was fought, development has to proceed apace. That people from those parts of the country are leaving seems to suggest a lack of confidence, a lack of certainty in the trajectory of this kind of economic development.
They're voting with their feet.
Exactly, and they're voting with their feet, so what is the message? That the grass is greener on the other side.
Well, where do you think this exodus will end, or indeed, will this exodus end, or is it going to be more to come?
I suppose the safe answer is going to be that it's not going to end. As to whether it would increase would depend very much on that feel-good factor and the sense of confidence being restored in the people that life is going to get much better for them here at the end of the day. So, I mean, I don't think you're going to be able to shut the tap off, you know. It's not going to stop abruptly like that.
Yes. All right, thanks for joining us. After the break, Evan Williams, not in Sri Lanka, but in the south of India, where thousands more Tamils are waiting to board dangerous boats, investigating how the smugglers are allegedly using the old Tamil Tiger sea networks to ply their trade. There was an exodus of Tamils from Sri Lanka to India during and immediately after the war. With little hope in the refugee camps there, many have headed off for Australia and never been seen again. But stories like these haven't stopped the flow.
I am also going to Australia and I get good education and good life.